Gentlemen, the concept of reciprocity has been borrowed from the radio cab service industry.
How we see we can execute a reciprocity, the challenge is,
a strategic blend of hard capital which comes from the business side.
Political by the government.
We have developed a new system for it. It's called ecosystem for affordable housing in India.
I think we should swap this in that case.
This should take 10 seconds and move on.
Okay, I think it's fine.
Hi, hello. Good evening, how are you?
Hi.
Okay, straight up the bat, I'll tell you, I'll have 10 minutes. We might jump in at any point of time if there is something that we feel that is not, which is good or which is not making sense to us for clarifications or for whatever else, the reason. Good luck.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Quality of life depends on ecosystem outside community. These are the tier one cities are basically too populated. With these tier one cities, there's a lot of pressure on those limited resources which are available. People from other states migrate, but when the migration, the number of people starts increasing, that is when these limited resources are under a lot of pressure.
See, I think there's too much understood about the problem. I think move on, you might be.
Exactly. The second point, what kind of strategy have we developed? The complete framework I'd like to call Kunal, who's going to explain the exact strategy that we plan to take forward.
So there are two parts, and I'll focus on the strategy for the tier 3 and 4 towns. The first step in the process is to identify the high and low resources areas, because these are the two catchment areas that will come into play. So identifying the low connectivity areas, using the public-private partnerships to actually build connectivity, to connect the high resources to the low resources areas, so that you can tap the ROI in the future. Not just that, creating jobs and other support services, commercial services is extremely critical because everybody at the end of the day is using livelihood as a key decision maker for the choice of residential area.
Now we'll talk about the strategy for rural development, because of course that is where people have so few resources and are leaving those places and creating too much population density in metros. The first is limited access to jobs and services is the main driver for migration. But the positive trend is that there is technology that is enabling remote both production and consumption. Take rural BPOs, for example.
I don't see in your proposal a solution to a problem. It's saying that you really want to change the problem itself. Namely, that is something which is quite unrealistic today. My question to you is, how does your concept, which you have proposed today, really fit into the reality on the ground?
You know, this is the root of the problem. We took a view that said all India, 25 years from now, if there is a constant influx from 25 to 51 to more and more and more and more, there is no way that the infrastructure can withstand.
So quickly tell us, what do you think is the benefit of going with your plan?
Critical thing.
That's what I'm gathering from your presentation.
Yeah, I know.
But you soon seem to be telling us that.
There are four states in India which contribute to 45 to 50% of the GDP. Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. The key states which are contributing to the labor workforce every year, 15 million people entering the workforce every year, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, you're not solving the problem there. You're shifting the problem to a new space.
Got it.
That's what you're solving.
Valid point.
Very valid.
Valid point.
We have to cut at the root of the problem. You can't shift the problem and be happy about it, even from a business long-term vision. I think that is a deliberate strategy for us.
Saru Chai.
Very good.
That's great then.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
What do you think?
They did have a concept which is really beautiful.
Right.
The difficulty is that today we have 22 million houses short. This is the current position. People can't wait for 25 years to get results. So we need a roadmap which says, hey, this is the result. We're going to reach there. But in the process of doing it, we are going to achieve this.
He finally agreed to our approach to some extent, I believe.
Yeah. Well, we did something different. We took a risk.
Hi, guys. Hello.
Good afternoon.
Please know that you have 10 minutes to make your presentation. So keep it tight, keep it crisp, concise, and to the point. So,
the idea of India is one land embracing many. In the future, coexisting societies is not an option. It's a necessity.
Presenting our concept of symbiotic living and sustainable communities. We call it reciprocity.
Gentlemen, the concept of reciprocity has been borrowed from the radio cab industry. An upmarket family staying at Powai would typically earn upwards of 2 lakh rupees a month. They would employ anywhere from 4 to 5 domestic help. So we are talking about a similar kind of a system wherein a premium housing or a budget family is able to sustain and provide employment to a low-cost family. The way we envision a symbiotic society, which we anticipate will house 100,000 families, out of the 100,000 families, 20 to 25,000 families will come from premium and budget backgrounds. They will provide employment to about 75,000 low-cost families living within the community. Any premium or budget family entering the community will have a contractual obligation to hire domestic help only from within the community as long as it's available. The second problem that we will face, typical problems that we have faced when we look at low-cost housing projects in the past, have been that the family ends up buying the low-cost housing but does not end up living there and rent out that low-cost apartment to someone else. They go back to their jhopatpattis. We plan to overcome this problem by introducing a non-occupancy penalty. Now, how this overall thing will work is that the entire reciprocity will have an administrative council. If a low-cost family wants to buy a low-cost housing within the community, they approach the administrative council. The administrative council will then look at their job skills and see if there are potential employment opportunities for them within the community. There is a probation period for a month, then the financial institution comes forward and funds the purchase of his apartment. So he typically ends up working over the next 10 to 15 years. A part of his income will go towards providing EMI for that house.
Architecturally, it's going to be a themed around a business park in the center with concentric tiers. So the tier one will be the premium homes, the tier two would be the budget homes, and obviously the tier three would be the low cost homes. And of course, the main feature to sell is 65 million square feet of business commercial premises.
So firstly, like he explained, that one premium house will support 4 to 5 low income groups. So assuming that sort of a ratio, if 8,000 tier 1 flats are there and 20,000 tier 2, so each tier 2 will support 2 low income groups, we can support a total of 80,000 tier 3, that is low income group houses. So that's how we have a number of flats as 1,08,000. So then we have a total residential area of 3,500 acres. Next, we came to the costing of the flat. There again, we had to offer value to all three levels. So first, we said the tier 1 people will have a flat cost of 1.5 crores. The tier 2, 50 lakhs, and tier 3, 8 lakhs. It can be scaled down for smaller areas and scaled up if you want to make it bigger.
Good job.
Thank you so much.
Thank you,
sir.
We did it as planned.
The execution was okay, but
I'm not sure you bought onto our idea so much.
I think a large number of ideas were alright in terms of creating a holistic or a sustainable kind of model. But I think the creativity element was missing.
I think as a whole, we executed our plan well. And now we just have to see whether they
have to do it better than us.
Good luck. As you said, this is not task for us, but a task for India. So our presentation is called Task for India. You already have a solution in hand. What we are trying to tell you is that why don't you apply the same solution everywhere else? So that's what we are trying to say here, sheltering India one brick at a time. Now, how do we expand that horizon of Hiranandani way of life? And what is Hiranandani way of life? Aage dukaan, piche makaan. Walk to work. Now, if we can do this model and replicate it across the country in a focused approach, one by one, then we have a winner on hand. Because of that, you know, the quality of life of large cities which you expect or what you think or what you dream is coming to you. In turn, what happens is the influx of population which is coming to larger cities will get reduced. Now, for that, so we are suggesting a public-private partnership model. It's a strategic blend of hard capital, which comes from banks, financial institutes, investors, and a soft capital, which comes from government, which is like subsidies or special incentive schemes, tax rebates and things like that.
Aage dukaan, piche makaan. Is it all about only dukaan? No, it's about your own world. Your world has to be on your feet. And that's the ultimate community. So I am terming it as micro community centers. You need to bring the office to your doorstep, you need to bring the kirana wala, bring the school, hospital, A, B, C, Z, everything to your doorstep. this is a concept of a micro community center, as simple as it. The micro community center connected through MRTS, intra MRTS as well as extra MRTS. Every village needs to be connected through an MRTS. The nation is connected.
So what we are saying here is a government has to institutionalize 4 R's. That's what our strategy is. So first thing has to be rewards. So to incentivize private players, the floor space index has to be more relaxed. Secondly, proper tax incentives, like IT companies get a tax rebate for first 20 years and so. Similarly, the real estate companies should also get a similar tax rebate. Thirdly is to cover the risk. Today, if a taxi driver wants to own a house and if suppose the house is worth 20 lakhs, he cannot afford a loan because banks consider him credit unworthy. That point of time, government can step in and provide the assurance on his behalf. He puts up a small payment, 25%, say 5 lakhs, and then later on pays in EMIs. So this is the last thing, regulation. This is a very important concept. One important thing which I have absorbed since I am from Bangalore is there's a lot of speculative buying. There are not so many customers, but just 20,000 flats have come up. And when you walk in the night on the outer ring road, you see only 100 of them just being lit up. So people are just putting the money. It's not basically a need, it's just they want to invest into something and get a return. So something like this, I think through regulation, government has to stop.
One of the things which has not come out strongly enough, and I'm specifically asking, do you have any thoughts on the affordability issue?
So I would like to put it really very simply. You know, affordability is a shelter for everybody. In this case, we have just given you a framework in which...
No, I'm not saying what you have given me.
Yes.
I'm asking you to give me something which has not been given. Thank you very much. If you look at the concept which they have done, it's a multiple location concept,
right,
which will become self-sufficient,
right,
in not one location,
right,
which could be in towns, which,
right,
could be in tier one, which could be in tier two, which,
sure,
could be in tier three, it could be in villages.
He needs solutions crisply. You know, initially we were not providing him crisp and critical answers.
That is fine, but he already has a model in place, right? What we are suggesting is that you do it with a newer way.
Exactly.
Of
you know, this is exactly where even the Hiranandanis have not done it. I mean, have we covered the entire society? And that's going to be the next 25 years.
You're saying something very big, actually.
It is really needed to cover everybody. It's not innovative, but it is a workable solution to a problem which exists for India. So it's really a beautiful thing.
I've got something to say. Shall I tell you that maybe you are the losing team? You think you're going to stay on the show? Why do you think you're going to be on the show tonight?